Everything that exists has a beginning and a reason for being. So how did Commission Transformation Ministries come to be? And what is it all about? Let's start right from the beginning. In 2004, a young man joined Chambogo University in Kampala, Uganda. Little did he know that it was the beginning of something great.
I was on fire for God, but I didn't want anything to do with leading ministry. However, God put this passion in me to help at least one fresher that would come the following year so that they don't lose their fire for God. And sometimes I say that's how God tricked me, if I could say, into ministry. The rest is now history, but the end result of it is that it led to a fellowship that still exists up to this day.
That's how he came to lead a group of young people in the university since 2005.
How does your journey in this ministry begin?
I joined campus in 2007 and I didn't want to be part of any fellowship. So I was tired of being in my campus room on Sunday. So I asked my classmate, where they go to church on Sunday. She told me there is this ministry that offers us free transport to go to church every Sunday. So Sunday came, I went to this church, but still I was like, okay, I've known about this fellowship, but me, I'll be just coming for Sunday services. I'm not willing to be part of any fellowship. So I realized they had lunch hour fellowships, but still I was hesitant, not until the Lord visited me himself through a dream, instructing me to join the ministry. So I had one day to just take myself to Peace Park for one of those lunch hour fellowships because I didn't want to disobey God's instructions. So I found myself in the ministry just like that. And still now I'm part of the ministry because God had set me up for this and that's the reason for me being in the ministry.
In 2008, Apostle Henry organized the first mission to Buwenge, Jinja District.
By then I was called Papa Henry because that is the title we found at campus for fellowship leaders. By then we were operating under the oversight of the youth ministry of my parent church. We weren't an independent ministry at that time, that's to say. That mission just came out of passion as well. But God surprised us with the level of success that he gave us in that mission. It was as if he was literally and vividly saying, I've called you for this. The first surprise was that over 30 missioners followed me to that mission. Mark you, it was the first mission that I'd organized, and in attendance I'd only attended one prior. That was about the time when I was joining the university. So it was all amazing.
Fast forward to 2011. The missions had now become one of the defining aspects of this ministry. The campus fellowship was running on a daily basis with a couple of programs on campus and off campus. And that very year, the KIU fellowship was born. However, the ministry wasn't identified as the Transformers Fellowship or Transformation Army till August 2012.
It was in August 2012 that we began holding our Sunday services. In addition to all other activities we were undertaking as the ministry.
In 2016, another vital part of this ministry came to light, the Transformation Music Ministry, TMM.
In 2016, we had a very first transformation worship experience, and in 2017, we had another where we recorded our very first album, Extravagant Love. Extravagant Love, that's
As I said before, I didn't have any plans of becoming a pastor or anything like that. However, bit by bit, our passion to serve God drew us to our purpose. So by 2020, we knew that much as we had started out by passion many years ago, it was now important for us to have some kind of structure, because at least now we had some idea of what God has called us to do. So we knew that we have the Campus Fellowship, that is now the Transformers Fellowship. We knew that we were called for missions, hence Transformation Army. Then we were running a full-time church and now the music ministry. So we had to come up with an umbrella name that covers all these ministries. Hence, Commission Transformation Ministries was the name that God eventually led us to. And that's why we are now sitting here.
By 2021, Transformation Army had held over 35 missions in 28 districts and reached over 500 schools in Uganda. The Transformers Fellowship had a membership in 3 university campuses. The Transformation Music Ministry had begun working on recording its second album, and Commission Transformation Church was growing.
church. I pray in church, pray in church. I'm left, but nobody's even me.
She has said, I was lame, but now God has healed me. God is a testimony to somebody. Come on, give us a voice, start a prayer.
In the form of denial, we saw a miracle of walking God.
Sometimes we go to schools and people ask us a question. Mufuniramuwa, how do you benefit from this? And some people think we have some funders abroad. Some people think we have some big projects that we are running. But as you can tell from the history you just had, God has always just provided miraculously. And those miracles are always people. He brings people our way. Sometimes we call them friends and partners. And every other year, every other time, we get somebody who believes in what we do. And they say, I would like to be part of what you are doing. And people have always been there for us. Even right now, the table still has room. You can join this ministry as a friend, as a partner, and do something about what we are doing. God has given us a great mission. He has given us a great assignment. As CTM, we cannot handle it alone. We need people that believe in this vision, that believe in what we do, that say the gospel must still be preached, schools must be reached, people must get saved, the kingdom of God must be filled up with souls. If you are that kind of person, I encourage you, come join us. Be a friend to this ministry. Be a partner to this ministry.